Welcome to the show, Not Exactly Experts. Rusty, Jarrett, myself, we're here for another episode. Guys, we've got something new in the headlines that's a little bit controversial. I'm kind of worried for one of us here who's taking a stance that we'll get to in a second. But before we get to that, Rusty, let's quick cover the latest poll that closed on Facebook and go over the results of that.
Yeah, we only put out one poll, which I think we're going to start doing, just one poll based off what we talked about. And that was for the first episode of this year, which was the drones episode. And again, the only question we asked was, should you be worried about these mysterious drones here in the Midwest? And it was overwhelmingly, people said nope. 78%, I think, said no. Only 22% said, yeah, you should be worried.
I'm disappointed. I'm disappointed in people. I thought me and Fur could add a little more fear-mongering and just have people more scared of the drones, because they definitely should be. But a loss is a loss.
Hey, yeah, let me just hand you guys your L right here.
Oh, man.
That sucks. Pretty surprised on this one. I thought most people would probably say that they were worried. I just feel like that's where most people go.
Yeah, it's the unknown. Like, you have something that is already kind of different and weird, like just drones in general, and now you've got something flying around that nobody knows who's doing it. But I guess our viewers and listeners spoke, and they're not worried. So
I think most people think it's the government. They just figure it's going to be okay.
I'm being prepared, so I'm stocking up on pickles and mayonnaise for the upcoming drone apocalypse. So.
You are disgusting.
I know, but I am prepared. If you listened to me and Ferd, you would have sided with us. Okay, you absolutely sided with us.
Let's jump into today's topic. So it's been in the headlines. It's been blowing up everywhere. Jillian Michaels has come out and made a few comments in an interview against an individual. Lizzo is her name. She's a musician, an artist, and is, I would say, above average or above the average weight. She's a bigger figure and has been very proactive about saying how she loves herself, loves her body, and so should you. And Jillian was in an interview, and the person that she was interviewing with said that they loved how they're putting images out there that we don't normally get to see of bodies that we don't get to see being celebrated, in referring to Lizzo. And Jillian said, why are we celebrating her body? Why does it matter? Why aren't we celebrating her music? Because it isn't going to be awesome if she gets diabetes. I'm just being honest. I love her music. My kids love her music. But there's never a moment where I'm like, man, I'm so glad she's overweight.
Go ahead, Rusty.
What do we take on this?
Well, my side on it is that I think it's fat shaming. I mean, call it what you want. She's shaming her because she's fat. You know, that's what she's saying. Even in a roundabout way, when you mention diabetes and why are we celebrating her body, it's another level of bullying. If you say those type of things, you're fat shaming. That leads to depression, which leads to anxiety. And that leads to destructive behavior, like overeating. Like, it just doesn't help when you're being a bully about it. You know, it's not like people are not trying, which I don't even know if Jillian Michaels knows Lizzo enough to know that maybe she's trying. She could be going into the freaking gym every day.
But Jillian Michaels is a trainer. She knows how to get people to lose weight, I would say. I mean, right? So, like, that's what her profession is.
Reach out to her and say, let's get together. I can help. Don't go on national TV and say, you're going to get diabetes. It's pretty much what you said.
This whole thing about body positive imagery and you should just love who you are and everything, and how being teased gets, you know, makes you overeat and everything else and causes depression. There's scientific research that goes in. If people who are obese actually do suffer from depression. That is a side effect of being obese. And I think this whole body positive imagery is dangerous. I'm being absolutely honest with you. I think if people tell somebody who is big, like, hey, no, you're good just the way you are. And I was in the same boat. I was in the same shoes. I was overweight. I was 310 pounds at my heaviest. And I realized that I needed to get into shape. I needed to do something. And so to celebrate obesity and to celebrate people who are overweight, I think is absolutely, it's like celebrating absolutely skinny supermodels. Obviously that's wrong. That's obviously not a healthy lifestyle either. You should not be happy with just being big. You can't, because I think it's a selfish move on your part.
But here's the thing, and you brought up a good point of this when you're talking about yourself. You said, I figured out that I needed to make the change. Nobody went on national TV and said, Jarrett, you need to lose weight. You're going to get diabetes. And that didn't cause you to go out and lose all the weight and feel better about yourself and start working out. That's what Jillian Michaels just did. She went on national TV, spoke in front of millions of people and said, you're going to get diabetes. And that's not funny. Like, she singled out a single person. She didn't talk about the epidemic in the U.S. You know, she didn't talk about just overweight people in general. She said, why are we celebrating Lizzo like this?
But that's where I think you draw the line, because
it's bullying. It doesn't matter if you're not wrong. She knows she's overweight. She's not stupid.
Someone did point out that Jillian Michaels, when she was on The Biggest Loser, their methods of losing weight were absolutely terrible. And that I agree with.
Yeah, that lifestyle is not sustainable. I mean, they're working out like crazy. They're basically dehydrating themselves to weigh in. You're literally burning yourself out. So from that viewpoint, I feel like Lizzo has a pretty good point of saying, like, who are you to be telling me that I'm overweight when you're essentially putting someone's body through potentially more harm than what mine's going through? It's not good for you to lose that much weight that quickly and then gain it back, and you're right back where you started.
You can have a great message, but if your delivery is off, it's not going to be celebrated. People aren't going to take it in and be like, man, she's right. She's going to come off as a jerk, and people are just going to be like, I don't want to associate myself with somebody like that. He says, yes, I need to do.
I don't think Jillian had malicious intent when she made these comments, but I can see it did come across to Rusty's point. Like, she didn't have to do this publicly, and it's so easy today. Like, people get behind a keyboard on their phone and tweet something out, you know, say something on Facebook, and there's not a human element attached. You're like saying something to a screen instead of to someone's face. So it's so easy to be so much more negative than what you would be if you were having a conversation in person, because when you say something publicly like that, right, especially about someone's weight, which is a very touchy topic. We don't know. Maybe Lizzo's trying very hard to lose weight and is not able to do it.
Let's just say that question is posed to you guys. Hey, isn't it nice to see that the media is portraying Lizzo and the body images that we see? Do you think that's so nice to see that someone of Lizzo's size is being celebrated? Is even that question appropriate? Is this like
a good answer to that? Is like, look, I think it's great that all of us should be celebrated, right? There's no reason that we should have one specific race or color or, you know, religion that is above the rest, right? Let's make it equal. Let's celebrate everyone.
And tough problem could have been done is that.
And by the way, she makes great music. I love her music.
Yep.
And none of this is a controversy.
I think it's completely different when you're a guy. Because when you're a girl, like, you grow up in this society that wants you to be as small as you can be, as thin as you can be, look like Victoria's Secret supermodels. And when you're not, like, it eats at girls' feelings. Like, that's what they feel like they need to be every single freaking day. They can't just be themselves. So I think when somebody like Lizzo comes out there and she's at least comfortable with herself, I think that's what people are celebrating. Not the fact that she hasn't done enough to make her more healthy. It's just the fact that she's comfortable enough in her own skin to just be herself and, you know, not be depressed about it.
And Rusty,
that's where I come from.
And I agree with you on that one, because we have, I mean, obviously there's rappers like Fat Joe. He's a man and he's fat and he's big and nobody cares. Like exactly. No one great has point. Ever mentioned. It's like, I think Fat Joe needs to lose some weight. Like, no, no one's ever talked about that. I'm not.
You've got to pick a side.
I know.
Jared.
I know.
There's no ties. No ties.
I know there's no ties. At one spectrum, there's this like, yes, it wasn't nice for her to say that, but there's another side that, you know what, I'm not big on celebrating people being overweight.
And that's where Jillian is coming from, Jarrett, right? So she actually used to be, maybe she's still this height. I don't know what height she is, but at one point she was 5 foot, 175 pounds. She was overweight for what's deemed overweight for that height.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, was eating very unhealthy and finally had kind of a come to Jesus type moment. It was like, I got to lose this weight. And so where she's coming from, she's saying, look, if I can do it, anyone can.
Yeah. And look, not everyone who works out is not going to be shredded. They're not going to have six packs. They're not going to be these models. That's a whole different type of meal prep, exercise, water intake. That is super scientific measures.
I mean, that has to become your job, right? If you're going to, it's the same thing. If you're going to be an expert in anything, right, you've got to spend way more time doing it than what we do, right?
Yeah.
So if you're going to be a professional athlete or if you're going to be a bodybuilder, that's your job. That's your 9 to 5. Right.
Mm-hmm. Have a legitimate podcast.
Yeah. If you're going to be the average Joe or Jane, like you're not going to achieve those levels. And so, you know, for someone, you know, like a Lizzo to be of the stature that Jillian Michaels is, I think is crazy to even think is possible because that's Jillian's job. That's what she does.
But to say that people can't lose weight. To say that somebody can't lose weight, I feel is a stretch.
But she didn't say that. Jillian, great point, Russi. There is a lot of genetics involved. And Jillian didn't say that she can't lose weight. I think she just commented on the fact of like, why are we celebrating that she's big? Kind of hinting toward like big people are unhealthy. Unhealthy people get diabetes, right? So I'm taking Rusty's side on this where I think it was going a little too far.
Yes, right now it might seem she's healthy and she's having fun and all this, but in later life, that's going to give you so many problems. It's going to give you so many problems if you continue that kind of lifestyle down the road. It's just going to happen. It's like smoking and drinking every day. Eventually, it's going to catch up to you. Right now, you might feel fine, but eventually it's going to catch up to you.
Liz is not going to hear that and go home and start this life-changing diet just because of what Jillian Michaels said. She's not going to go home and throw away all the cookies in her house, which would be terrible, by the way, because cookies are amazing, especially if they're Oreos.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yes. Double stuff, double stuff, mega stuff.
The most stuff.
So my question to you guys then, is there ever a scenario, a situation where you do approach someone about their weight? And if so, how and where, like, how do you go about it?
That's a personal conversation, a one-on-one, like nobody else needs to be a part of that. And I think it's more or less like, even then, like saying and telling people to do things is one thing. Like if you really care about the person and they're a friend or a family member, do stuff with them. Start a healthy lifestyle with them. Be like, hey, I want you to do this. Let's go and work out and we'll get on the treadmill for 15 minutes every day. Or let's go out and go on a walk every morning. Like that is going to impact them more than just saying, hey, you've got to change, right?
I agree.
I like losing that.
Losing weight and exercising with somebody is 100% better. Because you just, like me going up to anybody and point and say, hey, you're fat, you should lose weight, and then walk away, that's not going to help them. It's not going to help
them.
So
let's say I'm overweight, Jarrett. How do you approach me about it? Or do you?
And I don't know. See, this is the thing. I think if you don't draw attention to your weight, I'm not going to draw attention to your weight. But if you're always telling me, it's like, man, I'm so tired in the mornings. Oh, I can't believe I had that whole leg of lamb and cheese curds and I had a gallon of Mountain Dew for breakfast. If it gets to that, number one, I'm going to find an opportunity. It's like, finally, someone to work out with. Because it's like, maybe this is the kickstart that I need. It's like, hey, you know what? Let's go do this. Let's go walk for 5 minutes. Let's go, hey, I got a membership to this gym. Come with me. We'll go walk on the treadmill. We'll do this.
Right. What if I'm not saying anything, though? What if I'm not talking about my leg of lambs?
Then I'm not. If I think for me, somebody has to point it out themselves. I will never personally say anything to anybody unless they say it first. Like, I will never.
Because we know you don't like confrontation.
I hate confrontation. Hate it. I think someone.
But do you have like some sort of like, it's not like I'm just some Joe Schmo off the street. Like, you know me, we're related. Like,
right.
Don't you feel like you have some sort of responsibility to maybe say something or try and help me in some way? If you feel like my health is just going off the deep end.
I might think about it, but let's just say for some reason you wake up tomorrow and you're like, I'm done working out. My life is now about Twinkies and ho-hos and leg of lamb, and you reach 275, 280. And let's just say Katrina reaches out to me and rests. He's like, hey, first gone off the deep end. Like, I don't know what the deal is. Then yes, I would absolutely feel compelled to do something.
Sure.
Like Allie has told me several times, like, honey, if I start getting fat, tell me. I'm never going to tell her.
I don't know, though. I guess it just depends on the wife. If Katrina told me, like, if I start to get fat, like, I want you to tell me.
Would you?
She's the type of person that I feel like would appreciate if I honored what her request was.
She'd probably receive that well.
There's obviously – there's a certain way to do it. I'm not going to be like, honey, you're fat now.
Okay, honey, role play. I'm Katrina.
Hey, honey, I bought the groceries. I bought a gallon of peanut butter. I don't know if we needed it or not, but I bought it.
You sound nothing butter. Like Katrina.
This is me heavy breathing, by the way.
Look, it's something real straightforward to the point of like, dear, do you remember the time you told me at one point if X happens, this is me doing what you asked me to do. Simple as that.
X has happened.
No more peanut butter.
I couldn't do it. There's no. It'd have to be a good friend. I think it'd have to be a friend.
It's your wife. How is your wife not your good friend?
Best friend.
No, she is. She's my best friend. But there I'm not. I will never. She could get 500 pounds in a Rascal scooter. I'm like, honey, you look great. I will never point it out.
Feel guilty lying to her like that?
I think she would know. I think by the time she hits 5 bills and having a giant lollipop in one hand, I think she's going to realize I probably need to cut back.
5 bills.
Five bills, yeah.
If I start to get fat, you guys better tell me.
But that's the thing. Is this okay? Now this
but brings don't up, this, do it on social media so go. Everyone else sees it. And that's my beef with Jillian Michaels and how she responded.
Yep.
It is time for the Neek of the Week. The not exactly expert clip of the week. Guys, so Canada, they have a version of Family Feud there as well in Canada. And this was a sudden death overtime round. And we'll just, I'll let it go from there. So here is the Neek of the Week.
You're playing for $10,000. That's it. Whoever guesses this wins the game. Here we go. Name Popeye's favorite food.
Chicken.
Chicken.
Not chicken.
Spinach, Sherry.
Oh my God.
Show me.
You know what surprises me most about that clip? In Family Feud, they survey 100 people. 54 people knew it was spinach.
What did the other which people means, say?
Which means 46 people did not know that Popeye ate spinach. I wonder how many people said chicken. I bet she still probably would have gotten points.
She might have the number two answer.
I just love how she said it with conviction. Like she was certain.
Chicken. Oh my gosh.
That is the not exactly expert clip of the week. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Check us out on Facebook. Check us out on YouTube. Check us out on Twitter. We have a pretty big social media presence. Like our stuff, share our stuff, comment on our stuff. We appreciate all the support, and we'll catch you next time. Not exactly experts, signing out.
Chicken.